Hello, I'm Nate, aka B2 Mutineer. I usually make guides and discussion videos about RPGs, and my all-time favorite game is Dragon Age Origins. If you're here, you're probably interested in playing the game, but may have come across issues trying to get it to run on a newer PC with Windows 10 or 11. Dragon Age Origins is an old game. It came out in 2009 and never really received official support from the devs over at BioWare for it to keep running well on modern hardware and software. So people just discovering Origins nowadays often have trouble with the game crashing frequently or stuttering. The main problem is the amount of memory the game can use baseline is only 2 GB, and there's also some kind of memory leak, if I remember correctly, that never got fixed in the game's patches, causing all sorts of performance issues, most notably the crashes. The solution is something called a large address aware patch, sometimes also referred to as the 4 GB patch, due to the fact that it allows the application to use up to 4 GB of memory. It's not a complicated process, you just have to follow the steps. With this solution, I've easily gotten the game to run on every computer I've had, on Windows 7, Windows 10, and now Windows 11, with good performance and minimal crashing. Do note that crashes can still occasionally occur, so I recommend saving the game often. I'll explain the process for patching the game if you have the EA App or GOG version, as well as the Steam version. Keep in mind that I personally use the EA App version of the AO Ultimate Edition, so I can't say that I've patched the other versions of the game myself, but the process is essentially the same, with an extra step for Steam, so everything should work out just fine. Since the game tends to be really cheap these days, as well as going on sale very often, I highly recommend you pick up the GOG version, since it's DRM-free, and will generally tend to be the better version. I own the game on all three platforms, and the only reason I play on EA App is because that's where I first installed the game from after I stopped using my physical copy of the game, but I definitely recommend the GOG version. Before we begin, a note on audio issues. Sound-related problems don't seem to have anything to do with the LAA patch, so if you're having them, this is what I recommend. 1. Don't play DAO on a TV. The sound will most likely not work properly through the TV speakers. If you insist on playing on a TV, at least try to send the sound to your PC speakers or to some headphones. 2. If you're having issues with how the sound works on your PC, such as stuttering or you can't hear anything at all, open the configuration menu for DAO from the DAO launcher that you can find in the bin ship folder in the installation directory. Turn off all audio by checking all the boxes, and then turn it on again by unchecking them. If that doesn't solve your problem, try lowering the playback sound quality in your computer's audio settings. I am not speaking from my own experience in terms of these sound-related fixes, so I don't know whether they will work for your specific problem, but I thought I'd mention these just in case it helps someone. Let's get back to the patch. I'll start with how to patch the game for the EA App and GOG versions, because those are simpler than the Steam version of the game. Install the game normally through either EA App or GOG, whichever you own and or prefer. Download the Large Address Aware patch from Tech Powerup or the 4 GB patch from NT Core. These are essentially the same thing, so I'm giving you both as options just in case one of them becomes unavailable. The links for both are in the description. Extract the patch you downloaded if it's in an archive, then open it and choose the DAO executable file, daorigins.exe, from where you install the game and apply the patch. Now that you've applied the patch, comes a crucial step that many people unfortunately miss and thus continue to have issues. Make a shortcut of daorigins.exe on your desktop. You will start the game from this exe only. Before you start the game, go into the properties of the shortcut and check the following options. Under the Compatibility tab, check to run this program in compatibility mode for Windows 7. Lower in the same tab, choose to run this program as an administrator, and click Apply. To start the game, double-click on this daorigins.exe shortcut, and it should prompt you with the message of, "Do you want to allow this app to make changes to this device?" You click Yes. The game should run without issues, but I'll return to other issues you may run into after I explain how to patch the Steam version as well. For the Steam version, there's an extra step involved before you can apply the patch, because the Steam daorigins.exe file is encrypted, so it can't be patched. There is a very simple fix for this. You just have to get an unencrypted version of the exe and replace the one you have in your install directory with it. After you install the game through Steam, you will have to download and copy-paste the unencrypted executable. The one I recommend is on Nexus Mods, and it's called 4 GB LAA Patch Compatible daorigins.exe by Warlek. You can find it at nexusmods.com/dragonage/mods/5989. The link will also be in the description. It's likely you'll be able to find this exe somewhere else as well, but this is the version that I know and trust. After downloading the exe, you have to copy and paste it into the bin ship folder in the install directory where the original daorigins.exe file is and replace the original with it. The steps after getting the unencrypted exe are the same as with the EA App or GOG versions. Download the large address aware patch from Tech Power Up or the 4GB patch from NT Core. They are the same thing essentially, just offering both options in case one ends up disappearing, links in the description. Whichever patch you have, extract it if it's in an archive, then open the patch and choose the daeorigins.exe file that you just pasted into the binship folder in the install directory and apply the patch to it. Make a shortcut on your desktop of the daeorigins.exe file. You will start the game from this exe only. Remember that after you patch the game, there is another crucial step that many people miss. Before you start the game, go into the properties of the shortcut and check the following options. Under the Compatibility tab, check to run this program in compatibility mode for Windows 7. Lower in the same tab, choose to run this program as an administrator, and click Apply. With the patch and compatibility settings applied, your game should run well. I say should, because you may still have issues if you have certain settings enabled in your video driver. Open your video driver settings and make sure that for DAO, you only use application settings for everything. Once you're in the game, you can change various video settings from the game's options, but do not try to improve the game's graphics by having your video driver override application settings. It will most likely only cause you headaches. If you do want to improve the game's visuals, I recommend looking into mods such as Unofficial Remaster, Shiny Weapons and Armor, Higher Resolution Paintings, Clouds Retextured, Blood Retextures, as well as various mods that retexture or change the models of various weapons and armors. As for bug fixes, I highly recommend installing the mods Quinn's Ultimate DAO Fix Pack and Dane's Fixes. In any case, I hope this guide on how to make Dragon Age Origins work properly on newer PCs has been helpful to you. If you're looking forward to more videos about Dragon Age as well as other RPGs, do remember to subscribe and leave a like and comment while you're at it too. They really help.
I'd also really appreciate it if you considered joining the channel as a member to unlock perks like early access to videos.
This has been B-Tier Mutineer. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.